Yeah, so RAKBANK is the national bank of Ras Al Khaimah. Ras Al Khaimah is one of seven emirates in the UAE. It's the northerlymost emirate. It's very famous for minerals, it's rock particularly, and tourism, and a number of other industries like RAK Ceramics, for example. And of course, RAKBANK. So RAKBANK was founded in 1976 as the National Bank of Ras Al Khaimah, and nowadays is known more as RAKBANK, which is our brand. Yeah, I mean, RAKBANK, you know, as we said, it started out as a national bank and in the early 2000s morphed into a retail bank. And it was very focused on being very product-centric. So it started out with credit cards. And then when credit cards, a bit of competition came in, they moved on to personal loans and housing loans. And then when the competition got quite hot there, they moved into SME loans. So the bank's always been very product-centric. So really the vision actually we set out on 4 years ago was to say, let's create a much more customer-centric bank. And let's talk about how we can serve people from every part of the spectrum in the UAE. So the whole concept is a much more broader, balanced bank where we cover all the retail, SME, and wholesale banking areas. And we also started a financial institutions business that allows us to lend into other banks throughout the globe, actually. And RAKBANK was, again, its history was very sort of old-fashioned, I guess, is the best way to put it. But funnily enough, we built up a very strong reputation for our digital banking offering. But when I arrived at RAKBANK about 5 years ago, it struck me that, yeah, the functionality was good, but it looked very dated. It was very sort of old world. So at the time, we worked with Infosys to develop our digital banking platform. We combined our mobile and digital technologies together. So we've now got a very robust solution, but it's now about bringing things into the 21st century. I mean, everything looks and feels a little bit old. So we've got three major projects running in our innovation lab in the digital space at the moment. One very specifically relates to completely revamping the look and feel of our internet and mobile offering to change the way customers interact with us. The second one is around business banking. You know, RAKBANK is the largest small business bank in the UAE, and we think there's a brilliant opportunity to build a fantastic ecosystem for SMEs. Where literally RAKBANK can own that space. So that's the second one. And the third one really relates to customer onboarding. Again, in the UAE, it's fairly old fashioned in the way people open bank accounts and interact with banks. So we're starting with onboarding as the first initiative to really change the way we do our business using digital first. You've got to look at the legacy of RAKMoneyTransfer. I mean, before I came to the UAE about 5.5 years ago, I was in Malaysia for many years. And it struck me as very interesting when I came to the UAE that people would line up to banks and they'd take money out of an ATM and they'd go to an exchange house and go and transfer their money. It just didn't make sense to me. I mean, in Malaysia, for example, the banks really own the space of remittance. They don't change money much, but they own the remittance space. So we brought this whole concept with us from Malaysia into the UAE, and we were the first bank to really implement the whole idea of instant money transfers. So rather than going through SWIFT and it being very expensive and very slow, we built this capability from scratch. And we worked with a number of partners, including Finacle, in terms of how we could develop that infrastructure. Having done that and built a very brilliant proposition, we then said, well, look, the next thing is how can these customers become a RAKMoneyTransfer customer without having to come to a branch, without having to do various things. So, we worked very closely, again, with a number of partners to develop this whole concept of people being on board, just literally using their Emirates ID, their identity card, their phone, and begin remitting money straight away. I think it's opened up a whole new segment. I mean, again, one of the things that struck me as odd in the UAE is banks typically would not want to onboard a customer that had less than a certain salary. And I think part of that was because we weren't, finding ways to maximize that relationship. And it's a huge business of, transferring money. I mean, so many workers in the UAE will send 80% of their salary back home. So, we just saw this as a golden opportunity to target a completely new segment, not just for RAKBANK, but for the entire banking system. Bring it in through there, and then, as you said, grow and develop and see what we can do more with those clients. And look, at the end of the day, if all they do is just send 80% of their salary back through RAKMoneyTransfer, that's good enough. So, I see this as just an excellent opportunity for us just to broaden our horizons. Because the UAE is a relatively small market, there's a lot of banks, you've got to find ways to differentiate yourself. So RAKBANK's relationship with Finacle started in 2008. when we bought your first kind of electronic banking platform, which covered internet banking at the time. Then we upgraded our core banking system to Finacle in 2012, around there. And when I arrived in late 2013, you know, one of the things that struck me as a bit odd was our internet banking offering and our mobile banking offering were completely separate things. You know, one had a separate ID, separate password, separate beneficiaries. So we bought what was then known as your multi-channel framework. We implemented that about 2.5 to 3 years ago, which converged the mobile and internet platform onto one. What we're now looking at doing is saying, well, look, let's move potentially to your, you know, your new architecture, your DEH, as I understand it, to see how potentially that could work, how we could bring, you know, a whole channel experience into something that's much more, you know, open source, much more able to integrate with a range of things that we want to do, not just in the consumer space, but also particularly being the largest SME bank in the country, our desire to build ecosystems and so forth, you know, we think it's time to move that to the next level.